tonight. Chudia Paul, Cedric Bowen jumping up at center court. And the Bucks control number 5 will walk it ahead, and he has been flat superb for CSU in conference play, averaging just under 23 points a game, and Rousey gets the early assignment on him. Exciting game to watch should be tonight. Nimley top of the key, drives it, foul line extended. There's that pump fake. He finds a cutting Gomwer. Shot, though, is blocked, and now a quick whistle on the tie-up underneath. We'll give it back to UNC Asheville. And, Jonathan, that's something that Asheville has that not many teams in this league or really at the low to mid-major level have. 32nd in the country in block shots, and they get one there.
They've got a lot of length. They've got the famous Kenny George, too, from a few years ago, the giant, giant post player in Asheville history there.
Asheville starts 2 sophomores and a freshman in the backcourt, Rousey and Robertson. Kevin Vanetta as well, number 10. Harper went for a steal, couldn't get it. Rousey an open look, he missed it. Offensive board down low, but Arlon took it away. And now a bit out of control, and a whistle comes while Harper was still trying to control the basketball. Andrew Rousey has not scored it very well in Big South Conference play. He's only averaging 11.6 points a game, and he's down there. And fans feel maybe playing it up a little bit. He has a flair a little bit. We saw that last year late, but Rousey was leading the country in scoring and threes per game earlier in the year at 8 straight 20-point games, but he's only 8 for 38 from 3 in 6 Big South games, or 5 for Asheville.
Yeah, his numbers overall in total player, 18.8 points per game, but in conference play, as you mentioned, just down to 11.6. Robertson, on the other hand, has stepped up from 12.8 to now up to 14, so we'll see if that continues for Asheville.
Yeah, Asheville has a deep rotation. They play 10 players, double-digit minutes on average, go as many as 11 to 12 deep at times, and Barkley Redeball said challenge scouting them to make sure the personnel is grasped because they will shuffle people in and out. Two guys who can get to the bucket and hit from the outside, checking each other here in the early going. Shot clock down to 10. Good defense on this possession by Asheville. Late create by Harper, though, and Arlon goes glass for 2.
If you're the Bucks, you're hoping to see Arlon get going. He's had some shooting struggles, but he's still a really good player, very talented, takes a lot of good quality shots for this team. Really need to get him going offensively.
Arlon averaging 11 points a game, Nimley 18, Saunders 13. They account for almost 60% of the Bucks scoring. Harper has the first points of this one. Now Sam Hughes travels for UNC Asheville. Again, the Bulldogs, David Robertson, Andrew Rousey, Kevin Vanetta, all underclassmen in the backcourt. Chudia Paul and Sam Hughes down low. Paul at 6'9", 250, had a block shot in an opening sequence, and Jaleel Roberts comes off the bench. He had a double-double in Asheville's win over Campbell on Saturday and averages over 3 block shots a game. Cedric Bowen, a jumper that time, a fight for the rebound underneath. Wheeler and Vanetta crash to the floor, and the foul goes on Vanetta, so the Bucks keep it.
CSU's been able to pick up a couple, you don't want to call them cheap fouls, but not quality fouls that Asheville are really looking to get, and there's another one there. Rousey had one earlier there, kind of very far away from the basket, so we'll see if that becomes an issue for the Bulldogs.
Goes on Robertson, so he and Rousey each with fouls. Just about 2 minutes in here, 2-0 CSU. Man-to-man for both sides here at the outset. Arlon Harper, 1,423 points coming in. Gets 4 now. Talk about a friendly bounce there. 4-0 Bucks.
Looks like he thinks he may have had a good warm-up session. He's starting, wouldn't quite call it gunning, but he's taking his shots when he's available.
Robertson in the lane on Wheeler. That shot barely left his hand. Excellent contest by Aaron. Rousey will launch it from deep. It's off to the right, and Gomwer pulls down the rebound. Paul just 9 rebounds away coming into play from becoming the 28th player in Big South history with 700 boards.
Wheeler's got some sneaky long arms on defense like that.
Saw gets free away from the ball. 3 is off to the left. And the rebound, though, last touch by Asheville. So Charleston Southern will keep it. And that's something we've seen more of, Jonathan, these last couple of weeks, is Son Emily not always being the creator but coming off screens and trying to be maybe less reliant on him having to dribble around all the time.
Yeah, the Bucks have done a good job, especially starting early. We've seen some games where it just seems like Saw's the only Buck who's going to shoot. We've already seen Arlon get going. We've seen Sed and Paul get some shots. It's good to try and find some balance for CSU.
Asheville has opened 0 for 3 from the floor. Bucks are 2 for 5. Couple of buckets for Arlon Harper. Gets Arlon in the corner. Tries to drive it baseline on Vanetta. Nice pump fake by Bowen. Got by, but they recover. Harper's got 7. Arlon's got the feel here in the early going. And, you know, it's easy to talk about Rousey and Nimley. Harper hasn't really, statistically anyway, been at that elite player in the conference standard, but we know how good he can be, and he's off hot here tonight.
Second team all preseason conference. He's a quality player, and we've seen it, but hasn't quite made it happen so far this season.
Aaron Wheeler with his second block here of the opening sequence as he comes off the bench quickly in favor of Reuben Kane, but it bounces into the hands of Roberts, and the seven-footer for the Bulldogs banks it home. Perfect from the field was Roberts Saturday against Campbell. Asheville trailed that game by 10 in the first half, came back to win 69-65 behind 14-12 from the seven-footer number 45. Nimley might want to get Arlon a touch here. He's been feeling it in the early going. Good drive by Gomer, but the pass right through the hands of Bowen, and the Bucks turn it over for the first time here tonight.
Paul had a nice drive on that one, just had a beautiful-looking pass and just kind of slipped through Sed's fingers, and seeing Sed walk back up court, he kind of knew he blew that one there.
Will Saunders, Javis Howard come in. Nimley ninth, Saunders 15th in the country in made threes per game for this CSU team that makes over nine tonight, 12th most in the country. And Javis Howard, 6'8", freshman post from Irmo, getting some more early action of late. Sam Hughes, much improved player, talking to the Bucks post coach Ahmad Smith. He'll keep you honest from the outside, knocks down a three there. Hughes, a junior from Brattleboro, North Carolina, averages just under 6 points a game. Only his 11-3, but shoots it at close to 40%. Now he has a steal, and looks like an easy two. Missed the jam, though. How about that one? Hughes thought he was fouled. Looking back to the official, Nimley pushes off for Sed, and he will finish. Bit of a four-point swing there, and 9-5, Charleston Southern leads.
I think as the Bucks continue to get going in their offensive sets, Bulldogs don't seem to be guarding the player rolling to the basket. We'll see if they can get that guy more involved or if the length of Bulldogs inside will create havoc for the Bucks.
Two teams who like to shoot it from the outside at the rim on that last sequence. Missed dunk by Sam Hughes. He wanted the foul, didn't get it, and CSU gets an easy two the other way. 9-5, Charleston Southern on top early in the first half on the Big South Network.
State Farm agent to help you with unexpected savings.
Hello, beautiful. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Hi, Anthony. How much did my discount double check save me?
About $150.
Done.
I don't have State Farm, but insurance, find me money.
I got you a dollar. Oh, you almost had it. You gotta be quicker than that.
Having insurance isn't the same as having State Farm. There to help you with unexpected savings. That's getting to a better state.
See your local State Farm agent to help you with unexpected savings.
Brock, don't have a meltdown. Look, I know your patty melt is missing, but this bacon Velveeta patty meltdown is mine. I'd be upset too. Definitely not in the TV. Did you check the bookcase? Oh, my bad. It was under the napkins. Don't have a meltdown. Have a bacon Velveeta patty meltdown.
The bacon Velveeta patty meltdown with grilled onions and applewood smoked bacon at Hardee's.
Charleston Southern leading UNC Asheville 9-5. Talked a lot about Sean Nimley and Andrew Rousey in the pregame. Shame on us. Arlon Harper's open hop for CSU. Gets a more than friendly bounce there to get it to go. He's hit a three as well from the corner. He scored the Bucks' first 7 points. Javis Howard adds a layup after UNC Asheville's Sam Hughes missed a two-handed dunk on a fast break, and the Bucks up 9-5 here. Just over 4.5 minutes into the first half. We thank you for watching Charleston Southern basketball here on the Big South Network. Kevin O'Rourke and Jonathan Messenger bringing you the action tonight. Robertson, a good look at a three, 40% shooter from downtown on the year, but it rimmed out. Wheeler takes it end to end. He blocked two shots earlier, has just his shot blocked that time. Harper feeds a cutting Wheeler, blocked shot by Roberts, close to a goaltend. Harper takes it right back at him and arcs it in.
He's really feeling it early in this first half with 9 points already.
And Arlon hasn't taken a lot of shots at times this season. Son Emily has 241 shot attempts coming in. Harper 161. So Sa's taking almost 7 shots more per game, but it's been Harper out of the gate strong, and Bucks have to like to see that. When he's going good, Saunders, Harper, and Nimley, as good as it gets, big three in this conference. Good defense as well at the outset by CSU. They forced 3 turnovers, and Asheville just 2 for 6. Andrew Rousey has yet to score. He is 0 for 2, both coming from 3. Javis Howard has an early bucket, sets the screen that time for Nimley. Two-man game, Saunders. Tough to guard, and Saunders, nothing but nylon.
He was pretty well out behind that three-point line, too. Asheville knew that shot was coming. Can't do much to defend it if both your guys are running off a pick there.
Will started 1-for-8 from three against Presbyterian as Rousey gets a wide-open look off the ball screen. Too easy that time, and the Bucks coaches try to communicate on the sideline. Rousey on the scoreboard, but back to Saunders. Started 1-of-8 against PC. Then hit two, one with a minute 58 to go, one with a minute 1 to go. Two clutch shots to help the Bucks get a win. Nimley, quick first step. Harper wide open, left it short. And Robertson has the rebound for Asheville. Harlan flying around here in the early going and talking to Barkley right about, I think it was before the Liberty game, how do you get Harlan Harper going more consistently? Because I really thought at times 2 years ago, all-around game, when you talk about his ability defensively, arguably the best player in the league.
Yeah, he's doing a lot defensively too. Something we don't always notice, the matchups and things, but he's running around and just made a defensive play there. He's chasing Rousey around the perimeter. So a lot of his energy being used on the other end. We're not necessarily noticing it on that offensive end.
Again, we said Asheville plays a lot of players. Two reserves in there right now, Ahmad Thomas, Marcus Neely. Rousey got Harper up in the air, kicks it for Robertson. It's short, but the offensive board and the free throw line jumper is good for Ahmad Thomas, 6'3 freshman from Danville, Virginia. Again, lots of underclassmen in this lineup for Nick McDevitt's Bulldogs. He is the youngest head coach in the Big South Conference. No stranger to Asheville, though. He's been there for 18 years as a player and an assistant, now in year two as a head coach. Saunders going for three, number two, missed it. Wheeler active here in the early going, is there for the putback. And Charleston Southern sharp, lots of energy here at the outset.
A really nice play there by Aaron Wheeler to get in there. I know I seem to mention it every time I talk about Aaron. You don't realize how long of arms he has and how it makes rebounding a lot more easy for him. He can get in there, even though he's not got a big frame, he can get to the ball when things get knocked around like that.
Aaron's been a little quiet here of late, but active here in the first half. Couple block shots and gets himself on the scoreboard. 6'4 junior college transfer from Walter State. Averages 7.5 points, third on the team with 5 rebounds tonight. Sam Hughes had a 3 earlier, tries to take it to the block on Saunders, and a foul comes on Will. Just the second team foul on CSU, the first on Saunders, the 6'7 senior from England. Now Charleston Southern, 7 of 15 from the floor. Asheville just 4 of 12, and the Bucks in front by 7. Rousey, good contest by Washington, rattled out and falls off.
Rousey's had a rough night shooting so far, just can't seem to find a good rhythm offensively.
Will Saunders, Saw Nimley. Bucks the only team in the country with two players top 25 or better in the country and made threes per game. Somehow not a backcourt violation that time. Good save by King, and leads to the reverse lay-in for Nimley. Just the way he drew it up.
You saw the ref making the tip ball, so I don't know. I guess Ruben thought, didn't see it, and was trying to hustle after it. But either way, nice play. It bounced the right way for the Bucks.
Not a move you see on the basketball court very often. Grab it at your shoelaces and throw it over your head or under your head. One of the two.
Looked like Russell Wilson's two-point conversion yesterday.
18-9 Charleston Southern. Bucks playing excellently here in the early going and doubling up UNC Asheville on the Big South Network.
Papa John, pizza maker. Peyton Manning, playmaker.
New season, Peyton. You gotta have a kickoff deal to start it right.
Okay, like a superstition.
Yeah. You got any superstitions?
Score more points than they do.
That's not really superstitious.
It works.
Up your game with the new kickoff special. Get any large two-topping pizza, only $10. Add a mega chocolate chip cookie for only $5 more.
Better ingredients, better pizza.
Better football.
Papa John's.
Impressive opening stretch here from Charleston Southern, and you're watching it on the Big South Network. BigSouthSports.com is the source for all your conference information, news, results, and so much more, plus video on the Big South Network. presented by State Farm, now with all streamed events free and available on your mobile devices. All this and more at BigSouthSports.com. Son Emily, back-to-back 30-point games. He's been carrying the load in a big way for the Bucks, but it's his classmate Arlon Harper, two guys who have led this program on a renaissance over the last 4 years. Harper's had the touch here in the early going. He scored the Bucks' first 7 points, 9 overall, and CSU 8-for-16 from the floor, holding Asheville to 4-of-13 and on top by 9. Kevin O'Rourke alongside Jonathan Messenger here on the Big South Network. And Jonathan, on both sides, really have to like what you've seen so far.
Yeah, there's been a lot of energy for CSU. Even, you know, I don't know if Asheville normally shoots a lot of mid-range shots, but they've put up 6 or 7 mid-range shots already. I don't know if that's something they really like to take advantage of or if that's kind of something the Bucks defense have forced them into. But either way, that taking a lower percentage shot like that is good for the Buccaneer defense.
Really only negative so far for CSU as Will Saunders picked up a quick second foul before that media timeout, and Sam Hughes knocks down a pair of free throws for UNC Asheville. He's got 5 to lead the way for them. Rousey, Ahmad Thomas, Jaleel Roberts each have 2. Bulldogs just 1 of 6 to open from 3. Two teams who shoot it really well from the outside. Asheville 28th in the country in made threes tonight. Bucks are 12th. Some pressure there as the Bucks brought into the front court. Harper gets to the elbow. Nice pass down low for Bowen. Couldn't quite handle it. Arlon's got 1 3 already, and there's number 2. 12 points for Arlon Harper, 21-11, Charleston Southern.
5 for 6 from the field, 2 for 3 from deep. He's just shooting really well tonight so far.
Harper and Nimley as freshmen went against the Nashville team that challenged Syracuse that year in the NCAA tournament, beat them up in Asheville as Asheville's first conference loss of the year, one of only 2 on the season. Arlon had a career-high 28 in that one. He's off and running here tonight. Another missed shot by the Bulldogs. That time, dribble knocked away by Ahmad Thomas, but Harper gets it back. And now a moving screen is called on Cedric Bowen.
It looked like Arlon maybe kind of lost control of the ball. He was being fairly well hounded out there defensively by by Thomas, and Cedric was trying to set a screen, couldn't really find a proper spot for it, ended up moving a little bit too much there.
Rousey, Bucks said they want to double him or try to trap him a lot when he comes off ball screens, try to avoid letting him turn the corner, and Asheville turns it over that time for already the 3rd time here in the first half. And some of the size on the court right now for Asheville, Jaleel Roberts, 7'2", 230. Bucks continue to be the second best rebounding team in the league, almost +5 a night in the margin. They've got 12 boards to Asheville's 6 here in the first half. Nimley will fire a deep 3. It's Lawn. Lawn rebound for Cedric Bowen. Wheeler can't quite put it in. Roberts might have gotten a piece. The Bucks continue to hit the offensive glass as well. 18 offensive boards against Presbyterian, and that and turnovers, forcing turnovers, helped them overcome shooting only 31%. Halfway through the first half, CSU up by 10, and it remains that way. Good D by Bowen, giving up 5 or 6 inches to Roberts, but stayed right with him. Harper, stop and pop, missed it. Again, Wheeler in there for a chance at the rebound, but he touched it last, and it's going back Asheville's way.
You really like what you've seen from Aaron down low so far. He also hasn't been afraid to go back up with the ball in the land of people who are much taller than him, but he's been aggressive. He's had a couple shots blocked, but he keeps going up strong with the ball like that.
Wheeler's already got 4 rebounds, leads the way for CSU. Harper has 3. Rousey still searching for his first 3, searching no more. Nothing but net for Andrew Rousey, 5'10", sophomore from Lexington, Virginia, second leading freshman scorer in the country last season. He had 5 30-point games, first of his career, came here against the Buck Dome. He put on a show late to lead the Bulldogs to a win. Almost a steal that time for Thomas, but Nimley able to snatch it. Harper, another good look. Same spot he hit from before. He hits again. About 15 points for Harper. Arlon's 6-for-8 overall, 3-for-4 from 3.
You're just 11 minutes into this game. You're not expecting him to go for 40 or anything tonight, but if he can continue on a rhythm like that, he's going to create open shots for his teammates as well.
He tweeted at his backcourt mate, his buddy Son Nimley, after the Liberty game. Welcome to the 30 club. Arlon's halfway there already. Rousey hit one before. That one halfway down wouldn't stay. Vanetta, the Elon rebound. Hughes, open corner 3, missed it. And Harper has it for the Bucks. Here comes Nimley flying ahead. Hughes knocks it away. Another thing Asheville does well, active defensively. Top 3 in the league in steals and block shots. And there's a block there. And it looked like a goaltend.
I was just about to say, it looked like... looked like he might have hit that one still in the rim, but no call, so I guess you go with it.
And Nick McDevitt is kind of in disbelief and looks back behind the bench.
We'll see it here on the replay. I mean, it technically wasn't on the rim anymore, so I guess that's clean.
Bucks still up by 10, 24-14. Alley-oop for Roberts and an easy two for Asheville. Good playoff, the underneath out of bounds, and Roberts able to put it in. 6 points, six rebounds a game for him. Not a great score, turns it over a lot, but again, was perfect from the floor against Campbell. Had 14 points and 12 rebounds in Asheville's victory on Saturday. Nimley still looking for his first points of the game. Wheeler drives inside, and that's a charge. Roberts has a few blocks already, another there, but the foul anyway on Aaron Wheeler, his first, and CSU's fifth or sixth as a team.
I was curious to see if they were going to call it a goaltend. I wasn't even looking for the charge, so rest were seeing a lot different than I did on that one.
Sean Emily does have 2 points. 15 for Arlon Harper. Saunders has three, but he's out already with two quick fouls. Rousey gets Washington up in the air, weaves his way into the lane, and a blocking violation called on Gomwer, and that was kind of a bailout call for Rousey as he was a bit out of control with his back to the basket by the time that play ended.
Yeah, he seemed to be looking for it, but Paul was underneath that semicircle under there, so the refs are going to call that one that way all the time.
Rousey gets to the line almost five times a game as one of the best free throw shooters in the country. He'll be there when we return. Charleston Southern on top by 8 here on the Big South Network.
There's an amazing place where family vacation memories are made and shared over and over again, where new experiences never disappoint, and where the only thing better than visiting is coming back again. Book your family vacation at visitmyrtlebeach.com and discover amazing values on area accommodations and family-friendly attractions. There's never been a better time to visit Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, where family time has never been so much fun.
And it's game on, 4th and 18. Friends rushing the party in under an hour. Supermom's headed for the snack aisle. Ooh, this one's a scramble. It's all come down to this. Look at that air. She's got it. And there's that signature double pour. Crisp chips, crunchy pretzels. This crowd's gone crazy.
We did it, honey. Best party ever.
Yeah, we did it.
Bucks, go for the glory.
Charleston Southern is led from the outset. Kevin O'Rourke alongside Jonathan Messenger here on the Big South Network. Bucks trying to get to 5-2 in the Big South against the UNC Asheville team, one of three clubs in the conference tied for first in the loss column with just one. Bulldogs are 4-1 in the league, only conference loss against Winthrop. They come off a win over Campbell, and Jonathan Arlon Harper has been brilliant here in the early going, 15 points, but defensively for CSU, very good as well. 6 of 20 shooting from Asheville here so far.
Yeah, and Arlon's had the matchup on Rousey for the most part so far. Rousey not shooting great as much as he'd normally like to, just 2 of 6 so far, including 1 of 5 from deep. Arlon's been chasing him around that perimeter and allowing just difficult shots for Rousey so far.
Andrew Rousey, Saw Nimley, both picked to the preseason all-conference first team. A couple of early candidates for conference player of the year, but it's been the Arlon Harper show thus far for CSU. 15 points, 6 of 8 shooting, 3 of 4 from three-point range. Rousey able to get the first free throw, just under 90% at the line for the year. Gets them both. He's got 7, leads Asheville, 5 for Sam Hughes, 4 for Jaleel Roberts. He's already blocked 3 shots. He had 10 in the game against Charlotte, 8 against Western Carolina. Multiple blocks 10 times for the 11th leading shot blocker in the country in Asheville. Has switched to zone. Corey Littlejohn in the game for the first time. Where's number 22? Nimley has his first tray of the night.
That was from way beyond deep at that point.
That's Saz. Let's see, it's hard to keep track. 56th made three of the year. Saunders has 52, so 108 made threes between the two of them. Roberts goes to a left-handed hook. Nice finish over Javis Howard. He scored off an alley-oop on an inbounds pass a couple of minutes ago as well.
Yeah, he went in, switched sides of the basket. He had been attacking that left block earlier, so a little dexterity from him on this time coming from the right side.
Bucks 8-1 here at home this year. Asheville 3-5 on the road, but they're 2-0 in the conference. They beat Radford at Radford in that win over Campbell on Saturday. And Nimley tees it up from way back again, missed it. Another offensive rebound leads to another chance, and Nimley knocks it in from just inside the free throw line.
Seems like offensively, you know, our line carried the first 10 minutes for the Bucks. We're getting into a little bit of a saw groove right now.
Nice luxury to have two players as good as they are. Sixth highest scoring four-year classmate combo in Big South history. Rousey, a nifty crossover, but couldn't connect on the shot. Mentioned Asheville going deep. Bucks have gone deeper as well of late. Jabbar Washington into the rotation here the last four games or so.
You kind of wonder if Coach Radebaugh maybe just told Jabbar, hey, we're just going to have you defensively locked down. We're not looking much for you offensively. Just stay with Rousey, and he's done a good job there, chasing him there on the perimeter.
Jabbar, very athletic player. Bucks were optimistic about his potential defensively coming into the year, still working to grasp the game conceptually. Nimley, a heat check, count it, and the foul. Chance at a four-point play for Sa Nimley. Deep in the corner, defender all over him. I'll take it anyway.
Yeah, you called that one absolutely dead on, a heat check. I mean, who thought he was going to take it from there and then to get the foul on top of it? Just a beautiful bucket. Nothing but net on that finish, and now add Trident for the fourth point here.
So Sa Nimley now has 10. Arlon Harper, 15. They are combined 10 for 17 overall, 5 for 9. It's a big homestand for Charleston Southern. Again, it's early in the season, but if the Bucks hope to make a run at the regular season title, two or three wins on this homestand will go a long way toward that. They'll play Gardner-Webb on Saturday, Radford a week from Wednesday. Rousey in the corner, dumps it down low for Roberts. Bucks have been excellent, about as good as we've seen at any point in the conference season. Roberts has his second left-handed hook of the last couple of moments.
It's tough, tough matchup down there for Seth. There's not a lot the Bucks have on defense that can match up with Roberts. I mean, he's a legit 7 foot, so Seth can do all he wants, but at a certain point in time, if he keeps going with that hook shot, there's just nothing the Bucks can do. We may start seeing some double teams if Asheville continues to double down on Roberts there.
Asheville's been able to find some big bodies that have been real difference makers in this conference, and you don't see that a lot in the Big South or the low to mid-major level, but DJ Cunningham, who graduated last year, second-team All-Big South player. He had almost 100 block shots last season, averaged almost a double-double a game. Roberts has been number two to him in his career, but has done a good job stepping up this season and completes the three-point play there. Wes Johnson comes in for CSU, 6'8 freshman from Greenville, South Carolina, Eastside High School, and Roberts guards him down low right now. A foul there on the floor on Corey Littlejohn. And the Bucks will get a fresh 35 here with 5:16 to go in the first half. Charleston Southern 13 for 25 from the field, 6 of 11 from 3. 26 of their 33 coming from Harper and Nimley. Arlon's got 15, Saw has 11. Bucks, when they have scored 15 plus, the both of them in the same game, 15 and 4 in their careers. Asheville swept the season series last year. Bucks swept it the year before. En route to the Big South regular season title. Harper catch and shoot, looked online but short off the front rim. Rousey on a run out. He's a threat to shoot it when he clears half court. Nice spin move, gets him inside, and he'll go to the line again to shoot a couple.
A little bit of a late whistle there. Coach Radebaugh kind of upset with how delayed it came. It looked like the Bucks had gotten away with a good defensive transition play, and then that whistle comes and kind of slows everything down for CSU.
Talked about the big man DJ Cunningham for Asheville, who graduated last year, and Jaleel Roberts kind of following in that mold. Rousey, one of many very good Asheville guards in the last 5 years or so. J.P. Brim and Matt Dickey were the two guys who led Asheville to back-to-back NCAA tournaments. And some good battles from them against the Bucks when Nimley and Harper were freshmen. Rousey hits both free throws there, so he's perfect at the free throw line. And now has 9 points as Asheville is down by 8. They've scored the last 5 after the Bucks took a 13-point lead on Nimley's 4-point play.
You got to give Rousey a lot of there's another deep shot from Saw.
He's not going to hesitate. Heard it from Barker Edebaugh in the pregame. We know neither Saw or Andrew Rousey are shy to shoot it. Nimley's attempted the 5th most threes in the country. He's made the 9th most. New player in the game again for Asheville. It's Marcus Neely, had it top of the key that time on Gomber. They're working inside for Paul. Nice ball movement. Good dish back to the cutting Vanetta, and he lays it in.
Did a nice job drawing some contact, too. Might have been looking for a foul, but good strong finish by him there.
Asheville second in the league in assists per game, 60th in the country. They share it well with the number of players that they play. David Robertson, Andrew Rousey, their two leading scorers. Also, their two leading distributors. There's a guy who can score and hand it out as well. Nimley's scoring here the last few minutes. He's now got 13. And it ends the 7-0 spurt for Asheville.
Did a nice job of getting it high on the backboard there, too. Hard for even seven-footers to block it when it's that high.
Sast trying to stay with Rousey and able to do so there. Rather, Robertson. Vanetta get it the third time. This is Robertson with the ball, guarded by Wheeler. Now he finds Vanetta. Good size for a guard. Three rimmed out. Gomler, a strong rebound down in front of Neely. Bucks plus six on the glass thus far. 18 rebounds for Charleston Southern, 12 for Asheville. Harper had a steam down the left side. Rousey got a piece. Nimley and him chase after it. And Rousey goes sliding past it. Harper inside again. Got a little in too deep. Bucks fans and coaches wanted a foul call on Chudia Paul, but it doesn't come. 8-point CSU lead. Wheeler picks the pocket of Robertson. Nimley's got Rousey alongside him. Tries to draw some contact. Scoops it in. 15 apiece, Nimley and Harper. They've got 30 between them, with still 3 minutes to go in the first half.
Looked like Saw was expecting some contact. Yeah. Looked like Rousey kind of was going to throw it, just trying to be a little extra defender there with some footsteps.
Almost like the pulling the chair out from under you when you're backing somebody in the post. Saw, though, able to convert the free throw. Paul might have gotten away with an extra step that time. He's able to bank it in. So we've seen Jaleel Roberts score a couple of times in the paint. Chudia Paul as well. And Bark the Radabaugh will use his first timeout. Son Emily says, let's make it full, and we'll see if his head coach will follow suit. 30 seconds. He's not going to go with Sa for now, anyway. Kevin O'Rourke, Jonathan Messenger here on the Big South Network. 2:31 to go first half. And Jonathan, Arlon Harper, Saw Nimley, 6th and 9th in Charleston Southern program history and career scoring, and the accolades are many as we give you a look at a few of them.
Yeah, they've played really well tonight. I mean, one game certainly doesn't encapsulate all that they've done, but this isn't an uncommon occurrence for these two guys. They've played well. They're sharing the ball well with their teammates, too, and just their sheer presence on the court creates some extra opportunities for their teammates as well.
Swagger and confidence is something Barkley Redabaugh said a lot when Arlon and Saw were freshman Bucks. In that 2011-12 season, won 19 games. It was the program's first winning season in 16 years, and they made an immediate impact. We give credit to Paul Gomer and Cedric Bowen as well. Now in their final go-around here at Charleston Southern, going to be strange when they're not here, and they're trying to leave their mark this year and hopefully get to the NCAA tournament for just the second time in school history. Cedric Bowen has been scored on in the post, trying to return the favor. Can't hit off the window. And Asheville touched it last, though. So CSU keeps it when we come back. Bucks have led by as many as 13 right now in front by 8 as they go for their fourth straight win and a 5-2 start here in the Big South on the Big South Network.
At Jersey Mike's, we make a sub above. Bread baked fresh, veggies served crisp, meat and cheese sliced on the spot. Then comes the juice. Red wine, vinegar, and olive oil blended to perfection. It's what makes a Jersey Mike's sub a sub to behold. And beholding? Well, we think that works best with two hands. Jersey Mike's, be a sub above.
Charleston Southern 37, UNC Asheville 29. 2:15 to go here in the first half at the Buck Dome. We'd like to remind you fans, what's better than cheering on your Bucks to victory? Perhaps a trip to the beach? Well, you don't have to choose. Isn't that well and good? But now you can have both. The 2015 VisitMyrtleBeach.com Big South Basketball Championships will be played in beautiful Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, from March 3rd to the 8th. You can contact the CSU ticket office or visit BigSouthSports.com for more information. We'll see you at the beach. Another gorgeous day here in Charleston. Beach-like weather, at least for January, 65 degrees, and good crowd on hand here in the Buck Dome. Couldn't really tie those two thoughts together, but I tried. And Charleston Southern in front by 8 right now as play about to resume. 15 each for Son Emily Arlon Harper. Bucks have led by as much as 13, and they're shooting 48% from the field. Gomwer trying to get in the scoring column. Bit of a force there quickly in the clock. Not a good take. David Robertson takes it up the floor for Asheville. 9 for Andrew Rousey. 9 for the 7-footer Jaleel Roberts, who tries to set up in the post, and they work it down to him. Feeds a cutting Robertson. Left-handed shot rolled off, but he gets his own rebound. Bulldogs are 10 for 26 from the floor, but just 2 of 11 from 3. CSU, meanwhile, 6 of 13 from downtown. Three threes by Harper lead that charge. Bucks have played man-to-man here throughout the first half. Bowen knocked it away, comes to Thomas, elevates over Nimley and drops it in. There's the catch-22 at times for both Charleston Southern and UNC Asheville. As good as Andrew Rousey and Son Nimley are offensively, just because of their size, sometimes it's tough on them defensively.
Yeah, you know, looked like turnover here.
Hughes took it away off after Gomwer couldn't handle the pass, but for the second time, he comes up empty on a fast break. He missed a dunk before. Harper, he misses as well. Bucks thought he'd interfere with the basket as he really smacked the glass, but it ends up being no matter as Wheeler cleans up the miss. And now Nick McDevitt calls a timeout on the UNC Asheville sideline.
30-second timeout.
He really did smack the glass rather hard. And I guess maybe shook the basket a little bit, but Wheeler, sixth rebound of the game, able to get the putback.
Yeah, Wheeler's been a nice little presence down there. He's almost running, sounds crazy, but like he's the bottom of a 1-3-1, except almost as if they're running it on offense. He's just kind of running baseline to baseline, and he's just there. He's got a couple offensive rebounds now, a couple putback tip-ins type plays, and just the little hustle things that are keeping extra possessions alive for the Bucks tonight.
Charleston Southern opened up a lead as big as 33-20 on a four-point play by Son Nimley. Hit a three from the corner. The free throw as well after being fouled. Asheville countered with 7 straight. And Bucks have since pushed the lead back to 8. Just under a minute to go here in the first half. Another entertaining game between these two sides. We've seen quite a few the last few years. Two very good offensive teams like to push the pace and get up and down. Rousey, alley-oop for Roberts, and he finishes with two hands.
Not too much you're going to be able to do to guard that either. I mean, even that inbounds play where they had something similar, if he gets up in the air, I mean, what do? You throw a body in front of him, foul him, and hope he misses it maybe, but not too much defensively you can do to slow a 7-footer down.
Roberts now has 11, leads Asheville. Rousey handles the ball, shares it well. 55 assists, 32 turnovers coming in. A nice alley-oop that time off the timeout. Only a 4-second difference, game clock to shot clock. Rousey took it away. Bowen pins it on the glass and is called for a foul, and he cannot believe it. We'll get a look at the replay, but that looked to be a lot of basketball. It does go unsaid, though, and that's number 3 for him.
You know, it looked like Rousey had his forearm in Sed's face there, too. You kind of wonder if maybe the refs saw that contact and that's what they were calling, but obviously not necessarily a foul on Sed position-wise there.
Rousey only 2 of 7 from the field, but he's perfect in the line, 5 of 5. And he cuts the Bucks' lead to 5 there. Asheville trying to take some momentum into halftime as Rousey just took it away from Son Emily at half court. Was hounding him with the basketball for a good 5-10 seconds before getting the steal. And gets the second as well.
I know Rousey's had a rough night shooting tonight, but you give him a lot of credit. He's gone to the line 6 times now and been able to get in double figures. He's relentless. I know you've referenced Coach Radebaugh saying that he's not afraid to shoot it, and he's not afraid of if he's missing, too. He's going to find a way to put points on the board.
Good scorers find a way to get to the free throw line as well, and Rousey's done that in the first half. Down to 7 seconds to go. Nimley, a tough step-back jumper. You betcha. Wow, it's a big-time shot by Nimley. Robertson heave, nowhere close, and Charleston Southern goes into the half up by 6. Harper approaching 200 career steals, and that's his second here tonight. Again, Charleston Southern has employed the same starting lineup throughout Big South Conference play. They start the second half a little differently. Aaron Wheeler, Will Saunders in instead of Reuben King and Cedric Bowen. Saunders and Wheeler really effectively have played starters minutes for the entire season. Nice spin move to the baseline, and Aaron finishes.
It's a really nice move, and he used that line. I don't think Asheville was expecting him to take it up like that. They're expecting a kick out and kind of give him that baseline access.
6 points, six rebounds, two blocks, a steal. That is exactly the type of role they hoped he would play coming into the year. He's playing one of his better games in conference action of the night. Another basket in close for Asheville. It's Chudia Paul. And the lead is back to four for Charleston Southern. Asheville, again, after that slow start, they were 6 for 20, has been much better offensively since. Wheeler trying to get in the rhythm himself. Tries to scoop it in on Paul, and he is called for a foul, so Wheeler heads to the free throw line.
Bucks have been aggressive at the basket so far on their first two possessions, trying to go right at it and maybe draw some contact, and successful so far, especially for Aaron, who's now making a trip to the free throw line, but an easy basket underneath last time down.
Free throw line was big for the Bucks in the second half against Presbyterian. They hit 19 of 23 at the charity stripe, 23 for 30 at the game. Wheeler, for the entire game rather, Wheeler able to hit the first, misses the second. Wheeler just a 45% shooter for the season at the line, but been much better in conference playing of late.
And especially for a team that shoots just under 65% on the field, you really got to connect like you did there against Presbyterian.
Wheeler gets one of two. Rousey front rim on a three. Nimley looks to push it ahead. Finds Harper. Arlon, that quick first step. Off for Wheeler. Blew the layup. Gomber there to clean it up. Gets the bucket and the foul.
Nice play. Good hustle by Paul. I don't know if it's been by design, but Aaron seems to be the attacking force so far for the Buccaneers early in the second half.
Paul Gomber, the senior from Kaduna, Nigeria, he's in the scoring column now. As the basketball bounces in his hands, and he's able to put it up and in. 6'6", 220-pounder from Kaduna, Nigeria. Able to complete the three-point play. Gomber, the Bucks' leading rebounder each of the last two seasons. Fifth most rebounds in CSU's Big South history. Rousey will launch again, and this time hits.
And good defense there, too, by Arlon. I mean, Rousey's not lacking in confidence by any means, but continuing to put up shots well defended.
Harper has been loving going to work on that baseline. Almost a chance at a three-point play there, but instead, Harper is called for a charge.
Not much argument from the CSU bench. I think they kind of saw it the same way, that defender slid over just in time and made the proper play, as you see it there on your screen. Beat him by just a step, but that's all it takes.
Sam Hughes just able to get his feet outside that arc as well, and the charge goes on Harper. It's his second personal foul and CSU's first here of the second half. Asheville has opened up 3 for 4 to start the half, and again, since starting 6 of 20, they're now 9 for their last 14 from the field. Rousey almost throws it away. Vanetta able to get to it. Vanetta averaging 7 points a game, 44 assists as well, almost a 3-to-1 assist-to-turnover ratio for the freshman from Columbus, Ohio. Hughes scored on Saunders earlier in the half, turns it over that time. Nimley's got Wheeler to his right. He'll take it himself instead, and Rousey blocks it from behind. And that's one that Saw should have given up.
It looked like Saw kind of got up in the middle of the air there and wasn't quite sure what to do with it.
Saw Nimley, 5'8", at least listed at 5'8". Andrew Rousey, 5'10". Two of the better players under 6 feet tall you'll see anywhere. Two of the top players in this conference. They've been guarding one another quite a bit. Nimley from the edge of the pirate ship, missed it. Gomber keeps it alive, gets the offensive board, and a foul on UNC Asheville keeps it with Charleston Southern offensive rebound number 13 of this game for CSU.
You get into double-digit offensive rebounds at any point in time, you know, 15 is a high total for an end of the game. To be at 13 with 16 minutes to play in the second half, they're really attacking that offensive glass tonight.
Harper left Vanetta in the dust with that fake and able to knock it down from mid-range. And Arlon's really the guy who has that mid-range game for Charleston Southern. We know the Bucks like to launch from three. 12th in the country in made threes. They take over 28 a game, but he's kind of the guy who can get in the lane right outside the foul line and knock in those mid-range jumpers, and that kind of opens it up for everyone else too.
Yeah, he really rises above on those free throw extended jumpers.
He and Nimley now each have 17 points. It reinstates a 7-point lead for Charleston Southern, and Paul Gomber is called for a foul. His second, Charleston Southern's third of the half. 16:20 to go in the game. CSU in front by 7. Again, Charleston Southern trying to go 5-2 in the league. Asheville trying to up their mark to 5-1 and stay in a tie for first in the loss column. David Robertson's been quiet, stays quiet, but Sam Hughes is there to clean up the miss.
You know, I wouldn't be surprised offensively if Hughes keeps getting some points here. It seems like Will's not being as aggressive defensively because he's worried about picking up more fouls, but he may have to commit himself a little harder on that end if he wants to continue to make a difference.
Will trying for his second three of the game, missed it. Gomber gets the board. Nimley will launch and hit. Long rebounds off those missed threes. A lot of times pitch it back out and it's open. That wasn't terribly open, but Saw took it anyway and it was good.
Saw made it open despite being 5'6 or whatever it is it's listed as.
Third three of the night for Nimley. He's got 20. Rousey trying to answer. They call the foul on the floor, it looks like.
Yeah. And that's a tough one for Will, but Rousey did a great job of drawing that contact.
So that's three on Saunders, three on Bowen here early in the second half. 20 for Saw Nimley. Make it 6 out of 8 games in conference play. He's gone over 20 points. He has the Bucks in front by 8.
Brock, don't have a meltdown. Look, I know your patty melt is missing, but this bacon Velveeta patty meltdown is mine. I'd be upset too. Definitely not in the TV. Did you check the bookcase? Oh, my bad. It was under the napkins. Don't have a meltdown. Have a Bacon Velveeta Patty meltdown.
The Bacon Velveeta Patty meltdown with grilled onions and applewood smoked bacon at Hardee's.
There's an amazing place where vacation memories are made and shared over and over again. Where new experiences never disappoint, and where the only thing better than visiting is coming back again. Book your next vacation at visitmyrtlebeach.com and discover amazing values on area accommodations and fun-filled attractions. There's never been a better time to visit Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, where spending quality time together has never felt so good.
Charleston Southern's been really tough to beat here at home over the last 5-6 seasons. Bucks trying to go 9-1 at home on the year here tonight. They lead UNC Asheville 52-44. We thank you for watching Charleston Southern basketball here on the Big South Network. Kevin O'Rourke joined by Jonathan Messenger. Thanks to Jeremy Sullivan. Thankful for him as well for producing the broadcast. Son Emily's got 20. Arlon Harper has 17. Arlon had 15 early. And Nimley's taken the reins since. UNC Asheville led by 14 from Andrew Rousey, but the Bucks have held him in check for the most part thus far. He's 3-for-9 and 2-for-8. Passes up an open three that time. Sam Hughes giving Asheville a lift. That three, bit of a line drive, wouldn't go. Nimley gets a screen from Gomber. Works it back and forth on Hughes. And Cedric Bowen pitches it out for Gomber. Nimley, where's that three-point line? Let it fly. Missed it that time. And the rebound for Ahmad Thomas. That was pretty funny.
That was an NBA Jam heat check moment there.
A little slide step back to the three-point line. Couldn't get that three. Saw tonight is 3-for-9 from downtown. Bucks as a team, 7-for-17. Robertson still 0-for-7 overall, 0-for-4 from three. But Hughes, again, an offensive rebound. He's had a good game here tonight, 9 points, 6 rebounds.
Hughes has really been a spark plug in the second half. I think scheme-wise, they're not rotating on him after that pick and leaving him open, and he's made them pay a little bit so far here tonight.
Good defense by Sy. Stayed with Rousey, but better offense by Andrew. He's got 16. Barkley Radebaugh said to Scott Eisberg, ABC4 Sports Guy, it's going to come down to making plays. A little bit cliche, but it's true. Two teams that like to push the tempo, some guys who can flat score the basketball, and Rousey certainly fits that bill, and he gets the floater that time over Nimley.
these two teams really are mirror images of one another, the way they play the pace, the way they play the a lot of man-to-man, mixing some zone, point guards who aren't afraid to score either.
Arlon Harper, senior from College Park, Georgia, played in a summer league. A couple NBA guys, including Josh Smith over the summer, had it going early in the first half. Paul Gommer, who's been pretty quiet in this conference season. Is it a foul or did he carry it? Either way, it's a turnover for CSU.
I think they caught a carry is what I saw the far baseline official make.
That is only the ninth turnover of the game for Charleston Southern. Asheville has turned it over six times. Bulldogs can come within one score with a three here. They are only 3 for 16 from downtown tonight. Harper and Nimley have been kind of trading off on Rousey for much of the game. Robertson, a bit out of rhythm, able to find Roberts. Shot clock down to 10. Long three is up. Not a good possession for Asheville. Leads to a runout opportunity for CSU. Nimley goes at Robertson for a trailing Gommer, and his layup is good. Good job by Saw not to force a shot up there, and Gommer trailing the play gets his second bucket of the second half.
I think keying things right now defensively, Cedric's really fronting Roberts really well, and it's creating havoc just like he did there. He's able to come over and slide over and leave Roberts open for about 8 feet. That's not a shot Roberts is going to take either.
Nimley again picked up his dribble, able to get it off for Sed, back into the hands of number five. It looks to B.J. Mackey as assistant coach on the Charleston Southern sideline. B.J. and Ahmad Smith, the two fourth-year assistants. Tyler Murray, the newcomer. Nimley that time. Lawn, pretty good look, but didn't draw rim. Nobody picked up Rousey. Open look for him, and he makes him pay. Harper and Nimley looking at one another. Mentioned they've been switching off. Neither one picked him up that time, and too easy as Rousey drills it. That's now 19 for Rousey, and he's already got 8 since halftime. Couple of threes, and Barkley Redabaugh will take timeout on the Charleston Southern sideline. 12:21 remaining, 54-49 Bucks.
Brock, don't have a meltdown. Look, I know your patty melt is missing, but this bacon Velveeta patty meltdown is mine. I'd be upset too. Definitely not in the TV. You check the bookcase? Oh, my bad. It was under the napkins. Don't have a meltdown. Have a bacon Velveeta patty meltdown.
The Bacon Velveeta Patty Meltdown with grilled onions and applewood smoked bacon at Hardee's.
There's an amazing place where vacation memories are made and shared over and over again. Where new experiences never disappoint, and where the only thing better than visiting is coming back again. Book your next vacation at visitmyrtlebeach.com and discover amazing values on area accommodations and fun-filled attractions. There's never been a better time to visit Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, where spending quality time together has never felt so good.
Back and forth action we expected here tonight at the Buck Dome. 54-49, Charleston Southern leads UNC Asheville. Fans, be sure to visit BigSouthSports.com and check out the league's online store with the best variety of backseat to no one of Big South merchandise anywhere. Gear up with officially licensed apparel from all Big South schools. Watch for new products and even order gift certificates all at the Big South online store at BigSouthSports.com. Kevin O'Rourke, Jonathan Messenger bringing you this one on the Big South Network. Thanks again to Jeremy Sullivan and his talented cast of characters for producing. Bucks led by as many as 13 in the first half. It was a 6-point game at halftime, and Asheville staying right in the ball game right now. Andrew Rousey a three right before the break. He now has 19. A couple of trays already in the second half, and the Bucks have the basketball leading by 5.
Rousey's really started to get it going here in the second half as well. You knew coming in he was going to be a tough guy to defend, but you can't let him get going in these waning 12 and a half minutes to go here.
And if you're Asheville, any team really on the road in the conference, it's tough to win away from home. If you give yourself a chance late in striking distance and you got a guy like Rousey, that's kind of what you want. If you're Nick McDevitt and UNC Asheville, officials talking to him on the sideline. McDevitt, 2001 UNC Asheville graduate, played 4 years under Eddie Biedenbaugh, previous head coach at Asheville, was here for almost 2 decades. And Asheville has been the best team in the league record-wise over the last 6 years, 68-34 entering the season, 4-1 this year. Nimley's got 20 for the sixth time in eight conference games, 30th time of his career. Jabbar Washington instead has a step inside and draws a foul.
Nice good drive by Jabbar there.
Very good job. Aggressive to try to get inside. And again, he's moved into the rotation here these last four games and gets himself to the free throw line there.
Saw some space and started driving to the lane, and Little John didn't have much of an answer for him, and don't think the foul was intentional by any means, but seemed to be the only way he could slow him down was to grab him a little bit there.
6'3 junior from Michigan City, Indiana, connects on the first free throw. 12th game of the season Jabbar has appeared in. He is now 3-for-7 at the line for the campaign. Misses the second. Roberts takes down the rebound for UNC Asheville. Bucks were +7 on the glass in the first half. +9 now overall. Rousey knocks it down again. Third three of the second half. Hands down again, and Rousey's going to tee it up. And he is starting to heat up. Again, he had 35 last year, 10 for 16 from the floor, 6 of 9 from 3, and the Asheville bench pumped up.
Washington was closest defender, and he made the right play. Rousey faked left like he was going to pass it and just created some extra space for himself. And when he's that open, he's not going to miss.
Emily, see if he can go back to work and exchange blows with Rousey. Open look off the extra pass from Sid. Buries the three. Couple of good ones going at it right now. 23 for Nimley, 22 for Rousey. It's shaping up now here in the second half. And the Buck lead is 6. That is the 9th made three of the game for CSU. Hughes been a tough matchup for Saunders. Nice job to collect himself after losing the basketball. And spins back over his left shoulder to put it in.
They've done a really nice job in this half, kind of attacking in that paint. They're getting a good position and getting some nice quality, easy shots in the paint.
Asheville is now 8 for 14 since halftime. Really gotten it going offensively. One of the more efficient offensive teams in the Big South. Nimley, how about getting around that screen? Leaves it for Washington. Almost got the roll. Reuben King the board. Rousey took it away and gets it to Roberts from the seat of his pants. High energy on both sides. Couple of spark plug guards in Rousey and Nimley. Robertson is 0 for in the game. Forced it there. Turned it over. Jabbar Washington, some quickness. Almost a three-point play, but instead he goes back to the line. Really like the way he just does not hesitate.
I kind of worried there for a second. You saw him running down the court with Saw, like, oh, well, that's not a lot of space. And Jabbar didn't really care. He was going up with it the whole way.
Guy's only playing 6-7 minutes a game. He gets the basketball. He wants to get in the scoring column. And Jabbar will be at the free throw line when we come back. Another good one between these two. CSU leads it on the Big South Network.
This is Dr. Wendell at Trident. Go ahead.
We are a 24/7 specialty. The most important part of an ER doctor's job is to rule out life-threatening emergencies.
Copy EMS. That's an 89-year-old male with...
We're a level 3 trauma center, a primary stroke center, and an accredited chest pain center. We're trained for anything that walks through the door. A good day is when things just click because you know you helped all kinds of people out and you leave just feeling like, man, you did a lot of good today.
Back of the Buck Dome in Charleston, South Carolina, campus of Charleston Southern University. Two Big South contenders going at it tonight. Charleston Southern, UNC Asheville. Bucks have led it wire to wire by as many as 13, but Andrew Rousey has found the stroke here in the second half for the Bulldogs. 3 three-pointers and has them within 4. Jabbar Washington off the bench for Charleston Southern. Fouled on a drive before the break. And shoots 2 free throws here as Rousey and Nimley have themselves a nice little conversation at half court.
Probably saying, hey, I'm going to shoot another deep one. I'll let you shoot one too. How about that?
It really seems to be a rather pleasant conversation. Might have seen it behind Jabbar. Sal did not get Big South Player of the Week. Jerome Hill did. Asked him at shoot around, do you care about that? Just shook his head, no. He's usually calm, cool, collected. Jabbar Washington misses the second, got the first. Bowen the offensive board, though. CSU, their 17th offensive rebound of the game. They are plus 9 in second chance points.
They're really not letting Asheville's height get in the way of their offensive rebound.
There's that pick and pop. Nimley and Saunders. Will's been quiet. Foul trouble early as well hurt him. Nimley gets inside. He has 3 assists. Pass deflected, and CSU maintains possession with 17 on the shot clock. Asheville 8 of 15 since the half, 3 of 8 from 3. All of those threes by Rousey. Bucks have hit 2 threes. Quick one by Saunders that time. Little John touched it last, so another second chance for Charleston Southern. Will is just 1 for 4 in this game, 3 points, 3 boards. He and Cedric Bowen each have 3 personal fouls, both on the floor right now. Nimley's got 23, leaves it back for Saunders. Harper had 15 by about the 8-minute mark of the first half. Nimley's taken the reins since. Good ball movement that time. Good closeout by Littlejohn. 15 on the timer. And Littlejohn is called for a block. Asheville really getting into CSU, pressuring the ball that time, and Littlejohn picks up his first foul.
They're being really aggressive on their switches and really calling things out. They do not want to allow CSU to get any open looks from beyond the perimeter, so they're going to probably look to see that a little bit more. Maybe we'll have to see some more mid-range games or maybe even Cedric pop up and try and get some easy lobs inside.
That's actually Littlejohn's 4th, so Asheville, after being called for just 4 fouls in the first half, has already picked up 7 here in the second. 1-1 for Nimley, good on the first. Saw 5th in the league in free throws this season, comes in just under 83%. Senior from Lawrenceville, Georgia. He's got 25 tonight. 30, 30, 25, the last 3 for Nimley. Runner-up for Big South Player of the Year 2 years ago. He is right in the thick of that conversation here early in the conference season. Rousey, though, he's heated up for Asheville, does not have the ball right now. It's David Robertson, has had a tough night, and it continues as it was knocked off his leg, and Asheville turns it over.
You mentioned Robertson's been having a tough night. No points, 0 for 8, including 0 for 4 from deep. This is a guy who's leading Asheville in conference play and scoring, so to shut him down has really put more of the onus on Rousey tonight to try and score.
Robertson had 21, 18 after halftime Saturday as they came back to beat Campbell. Harper, aggressive drive, able to put it high off the glass. Again, Jaleel Roberts just smacks the glass about as hard as he can. Harper puts it in anyway. Big bucket by Arlon. Bucks have stretched the lead here back to 9. And Harper, his first points of the second half. He's got 19. Robertson still trying to get on the board, and now is. Timeout, Nick McDevitt on the UNC Asheville sideline. And some similarities this game to the one last year. You felt CSU's been in control, but Asheville's doing enough to stay right in it.
Yeah, I think it was the last 5 minutes or so where Asheville just kind of seized control of that game. They went on a big run and kind of closed things out. And Bucks have had a little trouble kind of closing out some of these games. I think it was the Western Carolina game where they opened up almost a 20-point lead, and Western Carolina just came storming back in that second half, and the Bucks were kind of able to hang on to that, but we'll see what the Bulldogs are able to mount here.
Charleston Southern has been improved defensively this season. Opponent shooting just under 42% overall, 35% from 3. Bucks struggled in their first 3 conference games on defense. Let's get a look at the packed house here at the Buck Dome. Such a fun atmosphere for college basketball. Last 2 years been great games in here against Asheville, another one shaping up to be that way here tonight. But again, the Bucks gave up 50% or better shooting to their opponents in their first 3 games, but they've cleaned it up since, forced a lot of turnovers last week, capitalized off them in wins over Liberty and then Presbyterian Saturday on the road. 25 for Son Nimley, 19 for Arlon Harper, scored just moments ago, and he's fouled there and head to the line. Free throws could play a big factor in this one as Asheville is in the penalty here with 8:32 to go. And CSU has only been called for 3 fouls, conversely.
It'll be big for the Bucks going forward in these final 8 minutes and 32 seconds, but a team that's only shooting 65% from the free throw line this year, they've really got to capitalize on Asheville's mistakes right now.
First free throw attempt of the night for Harper, 69% for the year, able to get the first. And that is Arlon's 20th point of the game, his second 20-point outing of the season, 18th career. 1,443 points in what has been a terrific career for him. Make it 1,444 as he nets both. Lead is 8, 65-57, 8.5 minutes to go. Got to get a hand in his face. It's not there. Rousey just barely lawn online. He's hit from that same spot a few times here in the second half.
He's got 5 shots from that exact same spot so far in this half.
Saunders gives it over for Aaron Wheeler. Gave the Bucks a spark in the first half. He has 7 rebounds on the night. Gets it back out for Nimley. Can he make it 3 straight 30-point games? Only 5 away. Looking for Harper off a screen. Has him. Arlon, 1 dribble pull-up. Rimmed out. Good board by Hughes. Good box out on Saunders. And Will is called for going over the back. That's his 4th. So Will Saunders, 4 personal fouls. With still 7:54 to go, Barkley Adebaugh tries to advise him on the Bucks sideline. Media timeout, CSU up by 8.
The grilled chicken sandwich from Zaxby's isn't just a sandwich. If it was a cowboy, it'd be a bold lawman in search of flavored justice.
Ma'am?
The grilled chicken sandwich meal. Grilled chicken topped with honey mustard and lettuce on a brioche bun, served with crinkle fries and a small Coca-Cola freestyle drink. Zaxby's, indescribably good.
No, you have to pull it, don't push it.
Papa John, pizza maker. Peyton Manning, playmaker.
New season, Peyton. You gotta have a kickoff deal to start it right.
Okay, like a superstition.
Yeah, you got any superstitions?
Score more points than they do.
That's not really superstitious.
It works.
Up your game with the new kickoff special. Get any large 2-topping pizza, only $10. Add a mega chocolate chip cookie for only $5 more.
Better ingredients, better pizza.
Better football.
Papa John's.
Charleston Southern trying to hold off UNC Asheville. Arlon Harper and Son Nimley, 2 big reasons why they've been able to do so thus far. Bucks up by 8. Up that to 15:35 for Sa, 14:44 for Harper, near 3,000 combined in their careers, and they've been at their best tonight, Jonathan.
Yeah, they really have been. Chipping in 21 for Arlon, 25 for Sa, and still just under 8 minutes to go. They can really add to that total. Both potentially could reach 30, but I don't think they're looking for a particular number tonight, just looking to kind of gut out this win.
Harper got the Bucks out quickly early. He had 15 in the first half, most of them coming in the first 10 minutes of the half. He scored the Bucks' first 9 points of the night. Nimley has had it going since. Sam Hughes continues to give CSU problems, and he's got a chance at a 3-point play.
Yeah, he's been really effective with that drive and kind of hook shot that he's used now multiple times in this game, and it's been an effective play for the Bulldogs tonight.
Hughes has 13 to go along with 7 rebounds. Will Saunders picked up his 4th foul trying to go over the back of Hughes before that break. And that time, Hughes takes it to the rim on Gomwer. Free throw good. 14 points for Sam Hughes. Only his 4th double-figure scoring effort of the season. Did have 22 and 12, a double-double in a rout of Gardner-Webb. Certainly Asheville's most impressive win in the conference. They beat them by 25. Nice alley-oop look that time, but not quite enough air on the pass. And it's deflected away and taken away by the Bulldogs. They can draw within a score here if they score. Robertson really having a tough go of it. Lucky not to turn it over there. Harper guards Rousey. 22 points for Rousey, 6 of 13, 4 of 11 from 3. Turned it over. Asheville's 8th turnover of the game, and Charleston Southern has the ball.
Bucks did a nice job trapping and forcing. Ball got tipped around multiple times before that final turnover there.
Wheeler takes it to the elbow. Out for Paul Gomwer. Bucks have gotten a little stagnant, seems at times. Here in the second half, they are 7 for 17 from the floor, and there's another foul on UNC Asheville as Ahmad Thomas tried to pick the pocket of Arlon Harper, came up empty.
They definitely seem to be a little bit more deliberate getting into their sets and looking for a higher quality shot, but you got to really credit this Asheville defense. They're not giving it to them. They're pressuring the ball high, and they're not afraid to get out behind that 3-point line, and there's nothing easy inside. With that last turnover we saw, trying to get Cedric an easy point close to the basket there, and Asheville's just not having any of it.
Asheville's done a good job defending the 3 this year. Opponents shooting only 31% from downtown against them. Bucks got hot there in the first half. 1-1 for Harper, converted 2 moments ago, And gets nothing. Bennett there on the first. 76% career free throw shooter. He's got 22 points here tonight. Trying to add to that total. And does.
After going 1 of 1 in the first half, the Bucks are now 10 for 13 in the second half from the free throw line. They're getting some easy points just like they should from the free throw line tonight, and that's going to be important in this final 6:45.
Harper's season high came against Wright State. He had 24. He's one off that mark right now. 25 for Nimley, 23 for Harper, and Sam Hughes banks in a three. I tell you what, I feel like in this building they have had several threes banked in on them on key spots these last couple of years.
Yeah, I think of that Wilmington one last year that seemed to – what are you going to do with a bank shot?
Brings it back to four. Wheeler, a nice move to get inside. Can't finish, but headed back to the line. So CSU, after attempting only one free throw in the first half, they've gotten to the line quite a bit since. They are 11 for 14 overall, so 13 free throw attempts already, and still 6:20 to go.
It's good to see, too, even though Asheville, we talked about a little bit today, they're a team with a lot of depth, and they've got several players they can kind of throw at you. Really going to test this depth. They've got multiple players with two fouls, including Little John, who's got four.
Wheeler now 1 of 3 tonight at the free throw line. 6'4 junior from Morristown, Tennessee, able to recover and get the second. 68-63, Charleston Southern. Asheville has never led. They have trailed by as many as 13. Ahmad Thomas finds Rousey, catch and shoot triple, rimmed out. Maybe payback for the one that went off the glass. Rousey's slow to get up, upset that that one wouldn't stay. And saying that's a foul to the official. Didn't get the call, though.
He's still chirping a little bit about it, too. He's not quite as focused on defending Nimley.
Nice little matchup there. Saw takes it to the foul line. Back out Jabbar Washington. Fancy dribbling there. Gomer picked up his dribble. Gets it off for Nimley. 8 to shoot. Saw inside the foul line. Threw it away right to Rousey. Bad possession that time for CSU. And Asheville, again, can come within one possession. They're leaving Thomas open. Not much of a threat to shoot from the outside. Shows why there, as his baseline jumper is no good. And Nick McDevitt hands up in the air, frustrated with that shot. Got to get a better one there for Asheville. A chance to get it to 3 or 2. Bucks will look for a good one here. And they'll have a conversation with their head coach, Barker Adebaugh, and his staff. They extend it to a full timeout. So we'll step aside for a break. Charleston Southern 68, UNC Asheville 63.
Hello, beautiful. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Hi, Anthony. How much did my discount double check save me?
About $150.
Done.
I don't have State Farm, but insurance, find me money.
I got you a dollar.
Oh, you almost had it. You gotta be quicker than that.
Having insurance isn't the same as having State Farm. There to help you with unexpected savings. That's getting to a better state.
See your local State Farm agent to help you with unexpected savings.
You'll find them inside each huddle, on every sideline, in every classroom, on each campus, from our neighborhoods to the corner office. Student athletes from the Big South Conference, serving in roles they've trained for all their lives. Leaders. The Big South Conference, developing leaders through athletics. Learn more at BigSouthSports.com.
Good atmosphere inside the Buck Dome tonight. Seen a good basketball game. Both teams shooting 45% from the floor. Bucks led by 25 from Sean Nimley, 23 from Arlon Harper, the sixth and ninth leading scorers in program history, trying to pull out a win, a big one for CSU here tonight. Bucks trying to get to 5-2 in conference play. Harper goes at Kevin Vanetta, 12 to shoot. Gomer straight on three. That is not the shot CSU wants. And it's short. Robertson trying to work on Aaron Wheeler. Gave the Bucks a lift in the first half. 8.6 rebounds overall. CSU is out rebounding Asheville by 13, 37 to 24. Vanetta, freshman guard, been quiet tonight. Sam Hughes is not. He's got 17 and 7 boards. Robertson continues to struggle. Jump ball, possession arrow. will send it Charleston Southern's way.
Bucks have extended their defense past that three-point line now, too. Both teams really getting out, extending their pressure. They're not going to allow open three-point shots unless it's a really good screen. And even if it is, I don't think either bench is going to accept it as a quality excuse.
Will Saunders has four fouls. He's been pretty quiet tonight as he got two early ones off the bench. He comes back in as Paul Gommer takes his seat. So Will's playing with four, three each for Cedric Bowen and Paul Gommer, four for Corey Littlejohn of UNC Asheville. No one else for them has more than two. Bucks are shooting two the rest of the way. Asheville yet to get into the penalty, only five team fouls on Charleston Southern. Nimley make it 27. The 7-foot Jaleel Roberts trying to block it, can't. And Saw continues to carry Charleston Southern here in the first half of the conference schedule.
That ball just hung in the air for a couple seconds. I thought Roberts was going to knock it out at any time, and he just couldn't get to it.
Harper and Nimley have traded off Rousey throughout the night. He's gotten hot here in the second half. Hughes got away with a travel. Big no call there. Good show by Saunders. Fights over the screen. Rousey will fire. Missed it. And Will grabs the board. Good possession that time for Saunders. Didn't let Rousey turn the corner, and Barkley Adebol really likes it on the CSU sideline.
Yeah, Rousey's been slow. He's just 6-for-15, but, man, he's had quite a few shots, at least four or five, just rim in and out on him.
CSU would really like to get a bucket here. Saunders looking for Sid on the baseline, still 10 to shoot. They get it back in the hands of Nimley. He says clearing on out with six. Got by Rousey. No one came to stop him. Missed the shot, though. Bowen keeps it alive, and number five has the board. Open three for Saunders. Really wanted that one, wouldn't go, but it's staying with CSU as Asheville is called for holding underneath. Barkley Adebol said in the pregame, really liked the way my team won on Saturday because we fought, and they fought on that possession there, getting numerous chances, and Aaron Wheeler will have two free throws when we come back. Charleston Southern going for its fourth straight win on the Big South Network.
Hello, beautiful. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Hi, Anthony. How much did my discount double check save me?
About $150.
Done.
I don't have State Farm, but insurance, find me money.
I got you a dollar.
Oh, you almost had it. You gotta be quicker than that.
Having insurance isn't the same as having State Farm. There to help you with unexpected savings. That's getting to a better state.
See your local State Farm agent to help you with unexpected savings.
Brock, don't have a meltdown.
Look, I know your patty melt is missing, but this bacon Velveeta patty meltdown is mine. I'd be upset too. Definitely not in the TV. You check the bookcase? Oh, my bad. It was under the napkins. Don't have a meltdown. Have a bacon Velveeta patty meltdown.
The Bacon Velveeta Patty Meltdown with grilled onions and applewood smoked bacon at Hardee's.
A rather exciting Hardee's commercial, a rather exciting game here tonight inside the Buck Dome. Charleston Southern up by seven. Bucks have led it throughout by as many as 13. Andrew Rousey has tried to lead UNC Asheville back here in the second half. He's gotten a hand from Sam Hughes, but Saw Nimley, Arlon Harper, they've combined for 50. 27 for Saw, 23 for Arlon. And Jonathan's been enough so far for Charleston Southern to stay in front.
Yeah, they're doing a really good job right now. They've decided they're going to push when they can, but they're starting to pull things out. They're not even really getting into their sets till about 22 seconds or so on the shot clock. Not to mention, their defense has been on point this last stretch here. Asheville has not scored in the last 3 minutes, 35 seconds.
Charleston Southern really getting it done on the boards again. 40 rebounds for Charleston Southern, 24 for UNC Asheville. Bucks are plus 11 in second chance points, 23-12. Two free throws for Cedric Bowen, 6'6 senior from Woodstock, Georgia. Missed the first. Charleston Southern tonight is 12 of 17 at the line. Only one free throw attempt in the first half. They've gotten there 16 times here in the second, making 11. Bowen gets one of two. So Bucks have split quite a few here in the second half. It pushes the lead back to 8. 3 minutes even to go. 22 for Rousey. Bucks have done a decent job of him for the most part. He's running off a screen right now. He'll fire from deep. Saunders the contest, no matter. Rousey took over in the final 4 minutes last year to lead Asheville back. Might try to do it again here tonight. He's got 25.
Yeah, they took him off the ball, and then now they're just going to run him off some screens, trying to get him some more open looks. We'll see what the Bucks
defense
can do.
Nice feed by Wheeler. Harper couldn't finish. Good backdoor cut as well. No call from the official. Arlon's down. Asheville has 5-on-4. Wheeler blocked the shot. A late foul call is going to give Rousey 2 free throws.
Aaron Wheeler, good.
Sorry, get a look at that Harper drive, and that could have certainly been a foul on Jaleel Roberts.
A little surprising it's not there with that much contact. On the other end here, Aaron Wheeler, after the play, kind of had a look on his face of disbelief, as most players do when they get a foul call, but looked like he really didn't feel like he got much of Rousey on that.
Rousey near automatic at the line, 90% on the year, has not missed tonight. He's now 7 of 7. He's got 26. And this would make it a three-point game, and does. 71-68, 2:27 left. So 5 straight from Rousey out of that timeout. He tries to get his bench fired up. Two of the best in the Big South going at it right now, Nimley and Andrew Rousey. Both have 27. Wheeler kicks for Saunders. Back left side for Sa. Can he make it a third straight 30-point game? Bucks might need it to get a victory. Bowen a hard screen. Harper a step back three. Buried it. That's a big time shot by Arlon Harper. His fourth three of the game.
He's been a little bit quieter here in this second half, but he's coming through when it matters most.
Rousey for the answer. How about that? Andrew Rousey, 30 for the second straight year here at the Buck Dome. 3-point game with a minute 49 left. Again, Mark the Redabot, Scott Eisberg. At shoot-around, going to come down to making plays, cliche as that is. There are being plays made left and right here in the second half by Rousey, Son Nimley, and Arlon Harper.
You could see his shot chart right now. You would see he's got a zone over on that left wing, and it's not like the Bucks are not defending him. I mean, he's just pulling up in some spots. I don't know how you defend a guy like that, even with a hand in his face. As you can see here, we're pulling it up for you. We're trying to see where he just takes off. I mean, Arlon's got a hand right in his grill, and yet it doesn't even matter.
Andrew Rousey fired up after that three. His seventh career 30-point game. Two of them have come here in this building. He had 35 against the Bucks last year, almost a year to the date. And again, he took over 11 points, three threes in the last 4 minutes. He's got a couple here in the last couple of minutes and puts it back to three after Harper hit a tough step back three from the corner. 100 seconds to go. Bucks lead Asheville by 3. Wheeler drives it inside, back out for Harper. 27 for Nimley, 26 for Arlon. Need to take care of the ball, get good shots here. Still 15 on the timer for Charleston Southern. Bucks trying to go 5-2 in the league. Asheville trying to get to 5-1. Harper finds Saunders. Nice extra pass. Rimmed out. Wheeler tipped it to Bowen. Another second chance. Charleston Southern 41-25 advantage on the glass. 21 offensive rebounds.
Aaron's job underneath. Paul, too, said's had a couple. That offensive glass tonight has really keyed this offensive attack.
And CSU is in the double bonus. Points here would go a long way toward getting a fourth straight win. They put it in the hands of number 0. He's had quite a night looking for more. Takes it at Roberts. Doesn't get the roll, but he's shooting 2 and a chance to give CSU a 2-score lead.
Yeah, I kind of see Arlon's face on that drive. I just didn't see a scenario in which he was giving the ball up there. He was going the whole way, and he was either getting the line or he was making a finish at the hoop.
Saad Nimley's been front and center for pretty much the whole season. Arlon actually third on the team in scoring behind Will Saunders, but he has had quite a game here tonight. Needs a couple of free throws here. Missed the first. And needs this one to make it a 2-score game. That's his first miss of the night at the line. He's 4-for-5, 9-for-17 from the field, 4-for-7 from 3. This to make it a 2-score game. And does. So Harper regroups, buries the second, 75-71 Bucks. And Barkley Redabaugh takes the timeout. 30-second timeout. So now one timeout left for Charleston Southern, 2 for UNC Asheville, and this game has not disappointed.
And coming down to this last minute again, and Bucks are in control. I'm curious to see what Coach Redabaugh kind of draws up defensively here. You figure the most important thing is Rousey's not allowed to touch the ball. Do not let him anywhere near it. Anything short of tackling him at this point is worth trying.
Rousey's got 30 on 8 of 17 shooting, 6 for 15 from 3. He is 5 for 9 from 3 in the second half. And he's hit shot after shot to give Asheville a chance here late. Harper and Nimley have come with enough answers for the Bucks. They've got 54 of their 75 as they've each hit for 27. 30th career 20-plus point game for Nimley, 18th for Harper. Asheville basketball, Charleston Southern in front by 4.
Rousey's off the ball. They're going to run him off a couple screens here.
Harper has him in the corner at the top of your screen. They hand it to him. Wheeler gets out. Rousey missed that one. Rebound loose. Asheville has it. It's Vanetta. Back for Rousey. Got to put a hand up. Take it inside the arc. Draws a foul. Missed the shot, but shoots two. And Bucks were upset a few moments ago with a foul on Aaron Wheeler on a Rousey jumper and upset there again. Here's the replay. Wheeler contending he was straight up, and that seems to be the case. That's a tough call.
Yeah. You know, the refs are going to make that call more times than they are not. And it's not even that Aaron played bad defense. You give Rousey a lot of credit. Knows how to draw the fouls. It's just about making these shots now down the stretch. And still going to be at least a one-possession game. So you wonder how quickly Asheville tries to foul if Rousey makes these. Obviously trying to get the ball back if they're going to go for a trap right away or not. I expect the Bulldogs to take a timeout if Rousey makes this so they can kind of scheme things up a little bit.
Asheville, two timeouts left, CSU one. Andrew Rousey, 31 points, 20 in the second half. He has not missed at the line, still hasn't, 10 for 10. And Asheville calls timeout, 33.1 seconds to go as Charleston Southern just trying to hang on and get a win here tonight. Kevin O'Rourke alongside Jonathan Messenger here on the Big South Network. Another terrific game between these two teams. Again, there's the timeouts. CSU shooting two free throws, have been for the last 6-7 minutes, and Bucks have missed some key free throws. Arlon Harper split a pair just moments ago, so there's lots of time left. Shot clock turned off, so some time for Asheville if they want to try to get a steal or at least get it in the hands of someone who they want to send to the free throw line. Of the five on the floor for the Bucks right now, Aaron Wheeler is certainly the guy you'd want to foul.
Yeah, you figure that's probably what Asheville's talking about in the huddle there about who they want, and definitely going to try and keep it out of the hands of Son Emily right now. He's CSU's best free throw percentage shooter.
CSU 70% at the line tonight, 14 for 20. 19 of those attempts have come in the second half. They do get in for Nimley. They come with a trap, and they foul Sy. Interesting there. I would have waited there with as much time as was left, but Nimley is fouled, and an 83% free throw shooter for the year shoots two.
A lot of different coaches, you know, kind of differ on what to do in this situation. Kind of wonder if their philosophy is not extend the game as long as possible, maybe try and start shooting more threes and kind of cut into things that way. We'll see what Sa does here with his two attempts.
He's 3 for 3 at the line tonight, 83% for the year, 5th in the Big South, gets the first. Son Emily thought toward the end of last season might have to get microfracture surgery on his knee. That's a procedure that has ended the careers of some players. Nimley's career still going. He's having a huge first half of his conference season. He's been huge tonight. Two clutch free throws, 29 points. Bucks lead it by 4. Shot clock turned off. Rousey got 32. Make it 34. Boy, he's good. 34 points for Andrew Rousey. 77-75. CSU in front. Bucks in front by 2, 21.8 seconds to go as Rousey pressured out near the three-point line, scoops it in for 2. 34 for Andrew Rousey, 23 in the second half. Two big free throws, though, by Son Emily, Jonathan. Those were about as perfect as they could be.
Yeah, all three of these guys who have had big games tonight. I mean, Rousey, Harper, Nimley, I don't know how you single out one of them as being better than the other. I mean, they've all just played great. They've all just been a real joy to watch here. Even coming down to these free throws, Saz 4 for 4, and Rousey hasn't missed from the line. He's 10 for 10. I mean, that's how he's really kept his game on track offensively tonight to keep him in rhythm, is keep getting in that line. Bucks denied him an excellent job there on some switches between Harper and Wheeler and Saunders. making him go to the line, making him go to the hoop instead of allowing him to get a good look at a three there.
Both teams have played very well for much of the game. Charleston Southern, again, has never trailed. Bucks hope it ends that way. 77-75. 21.8 seconds left. Again, they are in the double bonus. Need to get it in and get it to the guys you want shooting free throws. That's Son Imley and Arlon Harper. Will Saunders puts it in. He can run the baseline off Rousey's made shot. Ahmad Thomas pressures him. Goes in for Saad. Tightropes the sideline, and Kevin Vanetta gives the foul from behind. So Son Imley, with one free throw, will have his third straight 30-point game. Pretty good stretch.
Not bad at all.
Saad's career high before was 27 a couple of times. He is perfect at the line tonight, 5 for 5. 6 for 6. Again, hasn't hit the rim on the last three. 30 for Nimley, 30, 30, 30. Three in a row, Liberty, Presbyterian, and tonight against UNC Asheville. Two score game again. Four clutch free throws for Nimley. He's got 31. Rousey has 34. Trying for more. He's loved that spot. That one's way off. Cedric Bowen the rebound. Mug from behind. And Charleston Southern up 4. Pump of the fist there by Arlon Harper. Not quite over yet. And Seb will try to cash it in at the line.
Seb needs to make it at least one of these. I know free throw shooting isn't necessarily one of his strong suits, but if he gets one of these, I think you feel pretty confident if your coach rate a ball in the Bucks.
Cedric Bowen, senior from Woodstock, Georgia, a 64% free throw shooter coming into play. Way short on the first. CSU now at 18 of 25 at the free throw line. Sed is one of three. We've seen several players here in the second half miss the front end, make the second. Hopefully Sed can follow suit here. He does. 5-point Buck lead, 12 seconds left. Robertson, 0 for tonight. Pulls up in transition, still 0 for. Saunders the rebound, finds Harper, ahead for Bowen, and there's your exclamation point. Charleston Southern wins its fourth straight. 1/10 of a second left on the clock. The head coaches shake hands at half court. Just a formality now, an excellent basketball game here at the Buck Dome. And Charleston Southern finds a way to win. 82-75 CSU, 31 for Son Imley, 27 for Arlon Harper. It's enough to overcome.